Hello everyone. Welcome to our channel, Movie Story Recapped. Today I am going to explain an American epic science fiction movie called, Avatar. Released in 2009, this is the first part in the Avatar series. Spoilers ahead, watch out, and, take care. At the start of the movie, Jake is the first character we see. He was traveling through space in a pod, which was a space pod that traveled from place to place. After a protracted period of time, he finally comes to his senses, and he had been confined to this pod for 6 years. His legs had become paralyzed. At first, we couldn't understand that what is Jake doing in the space and for what he came here. But then we see some past scenes. The whole story clears to us. Jake had a twin brother, he was a good scientist. He wanted to go into space and he was fond of discovering new things. But he got into a fight with some people. And he was killed for the sake of money. NASA incurred significant costs in sending him to space. Jake doesn't want to waste this money and he wants to fulfill his brother's dream. He goes to space instead of him to see the other planet. He was ready to go there because he was paralyzed. The treatment for his legs was expensive. He has a hope that if he will succeed in his mission, he can earn a lot of money. Then he will use them for his treatment. No doubt he has no legs, but he was very hardworking. But he was so strong and he believes in himself. That he will do this. If we talk about that planet, there is no oxygen on that planet. The people who will go with him gathered at a place. There they meet with their leader and their leader making them understand. That how you have to face the situation there. And if you face any creature there, how can you defeat it? It means how to escape from it. Then Jake meets a man there and they do training together for 3 years and they become good friends. That man shows his avatar to Jake. There were the DNAs of the humans and other creatures of the planet where they were going. They start their project. The leader of that project comes there and they go to the head of the project. He was a businessman. He has started this project. She says to him that what was your purpose to bring Jake here? The head tells her that there is no problem with him. He is wise and do you know that why we are going to that planet? He shows her a valuable stone. He says that we will take these stones from that planet. The price of this 1 kilogram stone is 100 crores. It means it's 10 grams is worth 1 crore. You should stay silent and let it happen silently. In the next scene, we see that Jake is sent into a machine and he comes out after becoming Avatar. He was shifted into Avatar's body. He was happy after getting it. Tall ears, a tall tail, and a long braid of blue color. It means he was happy with blue color. Then Jake meets someone and he appreciates Jake. Because Jake was in the army before, his activities were good. He says to Jack that you can become more successful. And spend more time with the people of that planet, because the more times you will spend with them they will trust you. You know that the head of this project also wants this to take out more stones from that planet. At first, those creatures should be removed from there. And if you do this task it will be good. If you can't do this within 3 months then we have to attack there unwillingly. The war will begin. Because we have to get the stones at any cost and in return for this, I will make your legs treated. Jake agrees with this. Now they reach that planet and going there Jake who is now an avatar was happy. He starts touching the things. And then he sees there are huge animals. A strange animal starts chasing Jake. Jake jumps into a stream. Now he was separated from his team. There Jake makes a pizza for him. On the other side, his team searches for him but they couldn't find him. While thinking that it is a dangerous planet they move from there. Maybe Jake is killed. Jake was there in the forest and we noticed that a female was staring at him. Her name is Neytiri, and she was a creature on that planet. She was about to shoot an arrow at Jake but then a flower sits on her. She changes her decision and leaves from there. At night, dangerous animals on the planet start chasing Jake. They were moving to attack him but Jake fights back with them. He burns the fire to escape from them. Then Neytiri comes and saves him meanwhile. Some animals were also killed. Neytiri comes in anger. And she says to Jake while saving you my animals are killed. Jake says to her that why are you aggressive? If you cared about your animals so you shouldn't save me. Neytiri says that you are just a kid. Jake says that then teach me how to fight. With it, those glowing flowers sit on Jake's body. Neytiri was the daughter of the leader of this tribe. She takes Jake to her tribe. The people of her tribe want to kill Jake. Neytiri stops them but a creature doesn't like this. It was the same creature who will become the leader of the tribe in the future. But Neytiri's mother who was the queen there she allows Neytiri to teach Jake skills. On the other side, we see that Jake wakes up in the real world. It means in that boat. He tells everyone that I have taken the first step to winning their trust. Hearing it, they all become happy. Now Neytiri starts teaching Jake many things, like horse riding, etc. On the other side, we see the head of this project. She comes to that place with her team. There was their small cabin on the mountains and they can fly in the clouds. It is a charming view. On the flip side, Jake's training got underway, and he made excellent progress throughout. He learned everything about that place. Horse riding, how to hunt, and the biggest thing is how to love nature. Neytiri takes Jake to a place, she makes him meet with a bird there and she says that it can fly. Do you know its quality? It chooses its rider itself. And it remains sincere with its rider. It flies with its rider and didn't fly with anyone instead of its rider. The risky thing is that you also have to be careful before choosing it. It can also kill you. Now it happens the same, but soon Jake chooses that bird. Controlling it, he starts flying. Neytiri and Jake were flying on their birds. They were enjoying themselves. They see a tree and it was a beautiful place. Meanwhile, a dreadful bird starts chasing them, but they fight and defeat it. They save their life. Neytiri tells Jake that it was my ancestor's ride. It is difficult to ride on it. It is said that it can banish sorrows and can bring prosperity. Now Jake's 3 months are passed here and the colonel calls him. He says that I think you are forgetting what task I gave you. Jake says that no, I am not forgetting. Tomorrow is their event in which they will accept me. It means I will become their part. The colonel says that if you can't do this, I will send you again to the earth. Jake says that don't worry, tomorrow I will take them off from that place. The colonel says that let's see, and the next day comes, the event happens. Where they all creatures of that planet except Jake. Then they show Ella's tree to Jake, which was their pure tree. It always glows. Here Neytiri tells Jake that you can choose any lady in this tribe if you want. Jake says to her that I like you. Neytiri also smiles here. Then we see that the colonel is about to shed the present tree there. Because he was about to start his mission. Seeing it, all the people of the tribe become aggressive. Jake tries to stop them. But the humans were not stopping. Seeing all this, the creature who will be the leader of the tribe in the future attacks. Jake Neytiri saves him. Now the leader of the project says to Colonel that it is not necessary to get stones after breaking their earth or shedding their trees. Maybe these stones are all around. Meanwhile, Jake also comes and he makes the Colonel understand. He also says to the head of this project, why do you want this stone? They like nature. They will never leave this place, but the Colonel says that doesn't matter. If they will not move, I have already told you that we will fight. It will happen the next morning. Jake and the leader try to make him understand, but he wasn't listening. He just gives them a chance that you can again go to your avatar once, and can deal them. You have this last chance of. The leader of that project and Jake go to their avatar. They go to the planet again and Jake tells them everything. That I was sent here so that I can replace you from here because we need some important things from here. Hearing all this, Neytiri starts crying and screaming. That you deceive me. You were doing drama. The creatures of the planet imprisoned Jake and the project leader. Meanwhile, the colonel arrives there with his companion. Jake was forbidding him, but even then he arrives there. Now the people of this tribe start attacking them. But how much they can attack with their bow and arrow? The colonel starts throwing bombs at them. Due to it, the fire spreads everywhere. The people of the tribe get scared and start crying. Then a female creature comes to Jake and says while releasing him that save us. Meanwhile, the colonel shed their pure tree. Seeing this, they all were sad and they were aggressive on humans. Neytiri's father also dies during this. The head of the project and colonel orders to arrest Jake and the leader of this project. But then a pilot comes there, she used to fly the fighter planes. They were all now aboard a different spaceship after she had rescued them. There because of the firing of the colonel, the leader of the project was injured. Jake again comes to his avatar. But Jake sees that the people go to another place. He stops there where their pure tree was shed. It seems like Jake has escaped. He will never come to help them. But this time, Jack comes while riding that bird, on which Neytiri's ancestors ride. They believe that the one who will ride that bird can remove the clouds of sorrow. It means he can bring prosperity. When Jake comes to them on this bird, they all become happy. They think that Jake didn't escape. He has arrived to help us. Neytiri also becomes happy. Jake shares this with Neytiri's mother that one of my companions is injured. Is there any way to save her? She tells him that yes, if she will return to her avatar, so there will be chances. But at last, they couldn't save the project leader, and she dies. Jake announces in the tribe that we will fight against the colonel. They all support him. They become ready to help him. They were in a large quantity. Due to it, the colonel was also scared. But the problem is that he has many advanced weapons fighter jets. Jake and the other people of the tribe just have bows and arrows. Jake ignores it. Because he knows this planet very well. He decides that he will definitely fight for nature and the planet at any cost. He goes near that pure tree. He says to it to help them. The colonel is coming here to destroy nature, don't let this happen. Now the colonel attacks. He has brought the army in large quantities with him. At first, he shoots at that pure tree. But before this, the creatures of the planet come there. And they have prepared their government also. Jake was also coming on that bluebird. They all have the bow and arrow, but the colonel and his companions were heavy on them. Because of their advanced weapons and skills. On another side, the creatures of this planet have much strength. They put their willpower first. It was the strong thing, then the colonel starts attacking the creatures. Then the fighter pilot comes there. But before she saves Jake, that colonel also starts shooting at her. Due to it, the bird of Neytiri also gets injured. There was destruction. The new leader of the tribe was also killed because of that firing. The leader who makes fun of Jake. Now the next target of the colonel is that pure tree. Because he wants to control them while attacking it, Neytiri was also nervous. But here also before someone attacks that tree, Jake's prayer was accepted. That he has done in the front of that tree. Some huge birds were coming from the other side. The bullets were not affecting them. They attacked not only the colonel but also everyone else who was holding weapons. They throw their weapons. The plane from which they were about to do an explosion, Jake attacks it and fell it. That plane destroys. And they were saved from the explosion. Now Jake attacks the plane of the colonel. Due to it, his plane destroys. The colonel jumps from his plane. Jake was saved while stuck in the trees. And then the colonel sees that cabin in which Jake was. It means the human version of Jake who was faint. He thinks to kill Jake while attacking him. And after the death of Jake, his avatar character will also be removed. Before this, Neytiri arrives there. She fights with the colonel. But here she was getting weak. Then Jake comes there and Jake stops the colonel to kill his human version. But the colonel holds his braid and lifts him up in the air. He was blackmailing him. That I will kill you. But before the colonel touches Jake, Neytiri shoots an arrow which straight hits that colonel. This time, the colonel was killed. Jake also gets faint. Because he was also injured and he again comes back to his human version of the cabin. He couldn't breathe because there is a lack of oxygen. Then Neytiri comes here and she puts an oxygen mask on his face. They both smile because Neytiri saves Jake's life. Jake has saved their planet. In the last scene of the movie, we see that all the humans were sent back to the Earth. Only Jake was kept there. And some selected people with him. They will live with these creatures. Jake was changed into this avatar character for always. Now he was happy with Neytiri on that planet. With it, this movie ends. Thank you for watching.